Without doubt, Winks is the best I have ever called. It got to a stage where I described her as a champion, which is something I don't really like doing unless you firmly believe that this is something special.
She breaks all the records today. She's a champion, Winks.
And then as each year has rolled on, the global audience is now getting bigger and bigger. There's an enormous amount of pressure now as each race goes on that it's got to be perfect, really, because this is going to be there for history, and you just don't want to make a mistake in a race won by Winks. When she won the George Ryder, I think there was a long spiel about all conditions.
All distances, all challenges. Here's sweet 16 for Winks, making it back-to-back wins in the George Ryder.
And then when we got to the Queen Elizabeth, making it 25, a silver jubilee moment.
And here's her second Queen Elizabeth. This is a silver jubilee moment. On the throne for 25 consecutive wins to equal the record of the Great Black Caviar. Wins it easily.
Every time she stepped out, it's been another achievement or some record-breaking performance which I've been able to throw into the call, and perhaps a little bit of something else as well. When she returned in the Warwick Stakes in 2017, and she flopped out of the gates four lengths last.
And the gates open, they're off. The mare's missed the start by four lengths.
And I just said the mare's missed it, and a pause, and you could just hear the groan of the crowd. And it sort of gave me goosebumps there at the start. And she's still a mile back on the home turn. And it looked as though Fox Play had the race pretty much parceled up. Winks would have to do something special to get there. The only time I've called Winks here at Randwick where you've got the race callers lean up because they're going to the post, and you start to really lean right over to go with the horse if they hit the post. I think the call that day was, it's getting desperate.
Winks is down the outside. It's going to get desperate. Winks is going to Fox Play. Winks dives. Yes, she got up.
And more recently, Blake Shinn's ride on Happy Clapper, that really made the Chipping Norton. I don't think we ever doubted Winks would get there. But plenty of us would have had some doubt early in the straight, because Happy Clapper is one of the best horses that she's ever had to challenge for the most part of her career.
Bowman says, come on, girl! Winks moves up on the outside of Happy Clapper. It's a race today, but no longer. She starts to draw clear for a world record of 23 Group 1s. Winks by two lengths to Happy Clapper.
The second last day of the farewell tour, the win at Rose Hill on Slipper Day was outstanding, in the sense that it's the biggest crowd I've seen there at Rose Hill, and you could just feel the vibe. And when they moved out onto the track, I quickly just slipped in, and the champ moves out. Winks is out onto the track for the very last time here at Rose Hill, and the roar of the crowd was enormous. And at Rose Hill, I don't normally open the window. I thought, I'm going to open this window right up for the call of this race, because I don't want to miss any of the crowd vibe.
Now he shakes the rein of Winks and takes the lead from Brutal and Dream Force. And now she starts to go into overdrive. She's won four Cox Plates, four Chipping Nortons, and now four George Ryders. Here's the world champion, Winks, simply invincible.
So that was a fantastic farewell on a home track. What's it going to be like on Queen Elizabeth Stakes Day? It is going to be an enormous crowd here to farewell an Australian icon.